Thanks to all of you, our channel is growing very fast. The recent videos about top 10 settings of Word and Excel have been extremely popular. So here is the next one for PowerPoint. Top 10 settings you must do. So the first setting is about PowerPoint, but it is not inside PowerPoint, it's in Word. Why? Because often we need to convert Word documents to PowerPoint. And how do we do those? By manual copy paste. No. Save the Word document in OneDrive, open it on browser, and then File, Export, PowerPoint. This uses AI to automatically convert your Word document to PowerPoint, plus include pictures, icons, design, everything is done for you. So less effort, more impact. The next one is enable design ideas while you are working in PowerPoint. So you create a new presentation, even before you type a single word, it's going to give you design ideas. When you type something, it's going to adjust. If you type a lot of text, bullets, it's going to create smart art for it. It's going to find the right icons for it. Now, Word to PowerPoint used AI. You can directly use AI by going to File, Options, and say Show Design Ideas. Now, if you don't like this setting being on all the time, you switch it off, and only for specific slides, you can click on the design button. This point we have covered in Word, Excel, but equally important in PowerPoint. Why? Because often we get links to PPTs. You click on the link, you expect it to open in PowerPoint, but it opens on browser. You don't like that? Go to File, Options, and change this setting. That's all there is to it. Now click on the link, opens directly in PowerPoint. Now let's come to editing and creating slides. Now while editing PowerPoint, your best friend is selection pane. Now the setting is Home, Select, Selection Pane. That's it. It opens a separate window on the right side where it shows you all objects. Very often we struggle with send to back, bring to front, no need. The objects at the back are at the bottom, objects in the front are at the top. So you can even select objects without visually seeing them, change their formatting, reorder them, group them, lock them. It's an absolute pleasure to work with selection pane. Most people spend a lot of time searching for pictures and videos online without realizing there's a huge collection is available right within PowerPoint, even on the browser version. So go to Insert Stock Art and you'll be amazed. It's not only pictures, it's special videos which are optimized for PowerPoint. They are short, they are small in size, and they are loopable. So you can use them as backgrounds. There are illustrations, a large collection of icons, even 3D objects, and cutout people. So try it out, use them. If you don't find something in PowerPoint, then go outside. And from a legal point of view, by the way, these are royalty free. You have absolute legal rights to use them. When you download something from web, you're not so sure. I'm sure you are liking this video. So why don't you go ahead and subscribe as well? Because I'm noticing that many people who are watching the videos are not subscribing. I put a video every day, so you will miss out on those additional efficiency tips as well. So subscribe, share, like, and let's go on. A lot of content in Excel is copy-pasted reports, charts, visuals. So fortunately now, we have a direct integration with Power BI and many people don't know it. You go to Insert, you should see a Power BI icon. In case you don't see it, go to Add-ins and install it. Now what happens? You publish a Power BI report on Power BI, export, take the link from there, insert it in PowerPoint, put the link, and now you can have interactive Power BI within a presentation. This is absolutely mind-boggling, and many people who are using Power BI don't know it. So start using it now. I have a video to show exactly how to get Power BI into PowerPoint. Have a look. Often, I'm sure this has happened to you. You created a great presentation, sent it to someone or put it on someone else's laptop, or you put it on the AV guy's laptop on stage and things went wrong. Two things will go wrong typically. Fonts will not be there because you use some exotic fonts and that machine doesn't have. Common problem. Second, you use some video and that PC is not running that video. You're stuck. So how do you solve both these problems? When you are saving the presentation, go to File, Options, Save, and say Embed Fonts, All Characters. It will increase the file size because the entire font is getting embedded inside the PPT, but it will run on any PC even if that font is not installed. So it's your safety net. The second one, whenever you insert one or more videos in PowerPoint, go to File, Info, and there it will show you an option called Optimize Video. If you see that option, click on it immediately. Let it do its job without going into complexity of what it is doing. It's basically making sure that on any PC, these videos will work. Now let's talk about language and communication. You're presenting in some language, let's say English, but you know that some people in the audience may not know English language. They only know Hindi or some other language for that matter. Now, how do you address that? And there is a great setting called Subtitles. It can be even an afterthought. You started the presentation, someone said, sorry sir, talk in this language, but you don't know that language. So right click and say Subtitle Settings. Choose the language in which you are going to speak, in this case English India, and the translation or subtitle language, in this case Hindi. And now start subtitles and then just present as usual. As I was saying earlier, this is the Power BI dashboard or report rather, one page of the report actually, which is inserted into a live PowerPoint presentation. And I can interact with this. It is not a screenshot. Now this requires internet connection, obviously. It's going to take your audio stream, take it to Microsoft Data Center, apply AI-based voice to text, and then render it right within PowerPoint. So great way of communication across languages. Nowadays, we are presenting using Teams. Now when we were presenting using projectors, we had an option. What was the option? Presenter view. That means I am looking at the slides, the slide notes. I have the ability to jump slides, but people are seeing only the slide which I decide to. Now that facility is available in Teams. Many people don't know that. It's not called presenter view, it's called PowerPoint Live. In Teams meeting, go to share button, you know that. This is the option, PowerPoint Live. It'll upload your PPT first to Microsoft Data Center. You are still in control, but it'll run it from there. You are seeing the slide, but you're also seeing these annotation tools and the slide sorter kind of view and slide notes. What is the audience seeing? Only the slide you have chosen. There's one caveat there. By default, in this particular mode, your audience can actually change slides on their own. If you want it that way, keep it. If not, click on this eye icon to switch off that feature. As a presenter, you can see, you can jump slides, you can annotate, all that is good. As an audience, that individual audience member can say translate and their slides will get translated in the language they choose. Isn't that amazing? So start using PowerPoint Live. The last one is amazing. When you are presenting, you have no idea what settings and options are available to you, because you never clicked F1. F1 is help, by the way, during a presentation. So do it right now. Just run any presentation, and while you are running the presentation, press the F1 key and look at the dialogue. Read all of those options and think, which one will I use when? This will absolutely improve the way you deliver presentations. It allows you to draw on the screen, erase on the screen, so many useful things. It'll improve the way you deliver your presentations. So not just this one, all the 10 items I've covered will help you create and deliver high impact presentations with less effort. Go on, try these out, ask questions, tell me if I missed something, and most importantly, share it with people. I have another video of how to deliver great presentations. Have a look at that as well. So that's it for now. Thank you.